At Intel Developer Forum in San Francisco this week, the company showed off the first PC containing a next-generation chip based on the upcoming Skylake architecture. It's set to be in PCs and tablets in the second half of 2015.
This is our next-generation microarchitecture on 14 nanometer, and you should expect a significant increase in performance, in battery life, in power efficiency, all on this new product. Craig's showing you what is going to become the software development vehicle for all you software developers. This is just the first notebook in 2-in-1 form factor we've put it in. It's running full 4K video already. And again, this software development vehicle will be available to all software developers in high volume in the first quarter of 2015.
Skylake chips will follow chips based on the Broadwell architecture. While delayed due to manufacturing issues, Broadwell was introduced in tablet-focused Core M chips last week. It's due to be in mainstream laptops and desktops in the first half of 2015. The new Skylake chips will also pave the way for wire-free computing. The goal is to enable wireless charging and data streaming between PCs and peripherals.
Wouldn't it be great? Here I have a nice 2-in-1 laptop. But if I was able to go ahead and just lay this down in front of my desk, wouldn't it be completely awesome if just seamlessly it was automatically connected? He's going to go ahead and blink up there, and that's how I know he's getting a charge. And I can also do these multiple devices here as well, but we don't want to stop there. I can also charge with enough power all my devices all the way up to the laptop. So charging, not charging.
Wire-free computing won't be a simple upgrade, though. Users will need to upgrade PCs, and infrastructure changes are needed for wireless technologies. With reporting by Agam Shah in San Francisco, Nick Barber, IDG News Service.